Hello guys, welcome back to TouchStriders. Let's start with the first project of the post-processing series, which is cell viability. Before going on, let me remind you that all these data sets and results can be downloaded from the link that I put in the description below. And you need this data to follow me on this material. So the output files of the simulations for cell viability, as I told you, the cell viability is related to the islets, a set of cells, a group of cells that we put inside a well, and then we want to see if the provided oxygen is enough for them to stay alive. And the output of the simulation is something like this, a set of VTK files, which is a native, one of the native formats for ParaView. And the naming files like this would help you to quickly group them inside ParaView, and ParaView indeed automatically detects them as group. Let me show you. Instead of just talking about that, let me show you. So instead of adding sources, we'll go directly to open files. So the post-processing, cell viability, and then the files. Yeah, that's it. So ParaView has detected them as a group because of their naming. Name is key. If I open the group, then I can go to, for example, creating animations or working with the set of data files. But instead, let me first quickly show you how to work with a VTK file, because this is a first video, and then we can create animations later. So I open a single VTK file instead of a group. Okay, I have added something to the pipeline browser. Before going on, before you can add more filters and stuff and create a hierarchy, you need to apply things. When you add a new source or filter, you should apply it to the hierarchy or the object. So I apply it, and then it display the islet here. Indeed, I think this is the islet. Why it's like this? That's because of that's in the label. Yeah, that was because of that. So that was good. Let me also talk about this, because now I have to, because of the weird behavior that was in the beginning. So you can change the variable, let's say, the variable you want to display. Here we have only one variable, one scalar variable, which is nothing by this the oxygen consumption, oxygen concentration in this case, but also a solid color, which just demonstrates the domain of interest, and label. The label is a bit weird here. I don't want to discuss this because it's related to the computational part, about which I will discuss later. But and here is the scalar. I think it is a French, because the computational code was written in a French software. Maybe this is scalar in French, I'm not sure. But also, let me show you about different ways of showing and plotting the outputs or points for, we will discuss about this. This is the first order finite element, or the zero order, and also the surface, which shows us the computational domain, computational mesh or grid, which is indeed refined on the interface a bit, and the normal surface. When I switch back to the scalar view, the scalar variable that I have, you can see that we also with a symbol that is indeed a cube, sort of cube that shows a volume. It shows that it's element wise. So you can see, you can obviously see the values of the elements. So each value is represented by one element. So points don't have values here. This is element wise. Finite element. So you can easily switch between element-wise and point-wise in ParaView. That's pretty simple. Let me also show you that when talking about this, it's better to show you. So I think that's cell data to point data. Yeah, a good example of applying filters to data. So yeah, why not? Cell data to point data. It's applied to this this object in pipeline viewer, in pipeline browser, and then there are some sort of properties, we don't want to change them. And when I click apply, and yeah, now you see that it's changed to points, a point, well, point, because this is a point data. And then it's smoother, and the reason is, yeah, it's indeed, now it's interpolated into points. And you can see obviously that now each point indeed has a value. And if I switch back to the points, you can see that, yeah, that's indeed the points. They have values now. So that's the difference between element ones and point ones, finite element or representation of data. And this is a legend. This is a color bar. We have lots to do with this. This is very important. And before making the video very long, also let me also show you how to change the color scheme, which is yeah pretty needed for us, and also opacity. You can find all the things that you need indeed in this panel, in the property panel. And in order to change the color scheme, you can press this button, change choose preset. So that allows you to change that. And also, in order to have control on this color legend, you can go to this edit color. And this edit button is also something that is pretty handy, that helps us to have control on the color map editor, color map settings. But the thing is, I don't want to look at this as a tutorial, so I don't want to go through the different sections of this tool one by one. What is really important for me is just show you how I work with this. So this is the first video of the practical case, and I spent time on showing you different aspects. But from now on, I will try to just do the work and have some extra information during while I'm showing you the process and the workflow. But indeed, that's indeed all you need to know about ParaView. The previous video about the basics of that, and this one about how to import data and how to visualize that, different modes and different variables, the concepts of filters and the concepts of presets or color map settings. That's pretty cool. In the next video, we will discuss about how to create an animation out of this, and also what was very important for us to plot over a line to show, to act as a criterion for us to see if the cell can stay alive during our desired time or not. Okay, so see you in next videos.